Well, we're on board the Azamara Pursuit. It's literally 5 years ago this month, Captain Carl, that we were on your last ship with the same backdrop. And here you are again, but this is your baby, and it was anyway, but this is your brand new maiden voyage and shakedown cruise for this ship.
We sailed yesterday from Belfast. It's the first time we've embarked guests. We were laying alongside in Belfast under repairs and revite for 4 months, and it's great to finally get to sea.
This is something special. I mean, there's only three ships in your group, right? They knew that you from the Alaman, and they laid this on for you, didn't they? The company actually said you can come to the Alaman.
My boss, my CEO, his name is Larry Pimentel. He's the boss of Azamara Club Cruises, and this was his idea, just to send the ship with me to the Isle of Man. We picked up our maiden voyage. We've had a plaque ceremony. The first plaque on board the ship was from Douglas.
Wow.
I couldn't be more proud.
It must mean something special. I mean, you're steam packet based initially. Do you ever think this is where your life is going to go?
Originally I started with Shell in Castletown. After that, I worked for the steam packet, so I was on the Ben, the Peveril. I was on the Sea Cat Isle of Man, the Bellard, the Sea Cat Denmark. I did a little while with the steam packet, and in between that, I worked for another Manx company who were managing Fife's Bananas. So I worked for Fife's Bananas for 3 years, but out of an office in Douglas.
So, I mean, there's obviously different ships you could go for, sort of those massive ones, or this is very, very small, in what, 700 or sort of guests. Is this the thing you particularly like?
I love these ships. I first stepped on board, actually it was this ship, 15 years ago, and I felt like a square peg in a square hole. On my very first table on this ship, I was second in command, I hosted guests on the first meal, and they said, we were talking about where they were from, and they said, oh, we've been to Peel. I said, whereabouts? They'd actually stayed in my house when it was a guest house. So I felt like a square peg in a square hole, yeah. And I've loved it ever since.
I believe if Manxies get on board with you, you look after them?
As a rule, and it's yet to be broken, anybody from the Isle of Man gets to dine on the captain's table when they come with me.
That's great. Where's this ship going to go? Because obviously now you've got three in the group, you're expanding your horizons a bit, aren't you?
So this ship, our maiden voyage, revenue voyage, starts in Southampton on August the 1st. We sail around the Norwegian fjords, back to Southampton, then we're off to Iceland, then we do a little VIP cruise with the naming ceremony, and from there we move down into the Mediterranean, along the wine country in France. We're going into Bordeaux, places like that, all the way up the river. From the Medi we move out in November, out across to Miami for a day, just one day in Miami, then through the Panama Canal we go all the way down the west coast of South America, back up the east coast. Christmas, we're out of, I think it's Buenos Aires. Yeah. New Year's Eve is Rio de Janeiro. Then we go down to Antarctica.
So if people want to join you, which one would you recommend? Because obviously you're on for so many months, then you're off for so many months. I mean, if they want to get you on board, which would you recommend at the minute? You presume you know your itinerary a bit ahead.
So I'm on now till the end of September. Then I come back just before Christmas for the next 3 months.
So Buenos Aires down to Antarctica?
Antarctica,
that sounds great.
Then we're in Rio for Carnival.
Ah.
But if you want to check my itinerary, it's all available on the Azamara website.
Is this a thing that you would recommend people to go into, by the way, to the actual career of going into just being on board a ship, or is it something that's now going away? Because, I mean, is there money there, I suppose?
There are not many British sailors left, and there are not many schools left. When I started with Shell, and I was one of, I think, 80 cadets that only Shell employed in 1989. Now, I wouldn't say there are 80 cadets going through the entire UK system per year.
Wow.
It's just a shame that there are easier ways to make your money. It's a great life when you get to my position, a lot of responsibility, and there is a lot more responsibility now than there was 20 years ago because of international television.
Take us through how this one fits into, if people are thinking of cruising, where would you be in the I've done Seven Seas, and then I've also done Norwegian, so high and low. So where does this fit in?
So we're not six star, we don't pretend to be, but we are pretty much the best value for money cruising you'll get. We're not cheap, but we are very, very good value. We're almost all inclusive, so we call it more inclusive. It's difficult to spend money on board, and a lot of our guests go home and they haven't spent a penny once they've actually paid for their ticket. but the quality is phenomenal. The itineraries are great, and at Azamara we employ the best crew in the world.
Well, you mentioned you got some gifts from Mr. Lawrence Skelly, and you were given Manx ice cream, and I think you got kippers brought on board and all sorts of things, didn't you?
Okay, well, it's a year or two since I've been on the island, so we came in this morning. I've had kippers delivered. There's some Manx lamb come on board. I know Ian Davidson very well, so I had him deliver me some ice cream. I've been given gifts by the government, by the harbour master, by the tourism minister, and we had a beautiful certificate issued to all guests and all crew today by the Isle of Man post office. It feels just like Christmas.
Well, here's my bit to add to it. Where's it gone? Hang on. Ugh. Okay, hang on. You hold that.
I'll hold that.
Let me just get this out. This.
It's upside down.
It's upside down.
It is upside down.
Brilliant.
He has had too much wine, hasn't he?
I bought it. I bought this for you.
Thank you very much.
It's a tea towel. Now, will you use that or does it go to somebody else?
I will dry my dishes with pride.